Hi friends, welcome to Sankalp Study Success. In this particular session, I'll discuss some of the examples on DFS. Okay, we can find out the spanning tree with the help of DFS now. So in previous lectures, I explained in detail how we can find out the spanning tree with the help of DFS and BFS. Okay, so in this session, I'll take three examples. Okay, I'll discuss how to draw a spanning tree with the help of DFS. So in the previous session, I gave this as a homework, right? So please watch this video whether it is correct or not. So this is our first question. Okay. So in the first question, what they mention, A should be a root node. Okay. So what is the criteria? What is the condition for DFS? What is the procedure? We have to follow the procedure. See the simple steps too. First, we have to choose the root node. Okay. And then we have to visit the next vertex. We have to explore this root node and we have to take only one vertex. Okay, not all the vertices, not all the incident vertices, we have to choose only one vertex, that is DFS. So here, what is our root node? A is our root node, right? Okay, good. Now write down here, this is a rough work, ma. No need to write in the exam. Okay, for a better understanding, I write here like this. For A, how many incident vertices? A have the edge with C and B, right? So can we take all these C, B? No. Just we have to explore only one vertex. We have to explore only one vertex called what? C. Okay. So I take C as the next vertex. And next where I am? In C. Okay. I am at C. Now explore this C. What are the vertices at incident with C? So C have A and B and what? D. Okay. So here you can take any one of them, but A you will already visited, so you can eliminate this one, and next one B and D. So among B and D you can take any one, B or D. Okay, but I choose D here. You can take B. Okay, no problem, but here I choose what? D. Okay, and then what is the next explorer vertex? That is D. So D have a edge with C and the next E and the next F. Okay, and the first, what is the first one? C is the first one. So it is already visited, so no need to take it again. And the next element is E and F. Okay, so I take it as a E. E is my next vertex. Okay, now what is my new vertex? E. Explore this vertex and write down only one vertex incident with the E. So E having connection with D and F and H, right ma? So D, H, three connections are there. Okay, so D already visited, no? So you can eliminate this one, and F and H. So among F and H, you can eliminate, you can take any one. So I can take F. Okay, F as a next vertex. Now what is the next vertex? F. Now write down what are the next incident vertex for the F. F have a connection with D and G and E. Right, three are there. F to D, F to E, and F to G. Okay, so D is already visited, and what about G? G is not visited, but E already visited. First remove the visited vertices. Okay na? First remove the visited vertices. So only element is what? G. Okay, fine. Now write down what is the next element for the G. For G we have how many vertices? F and H and J. Okay, so first remove what already visited vertices. F is already visited and H not visited, and J is also not visited. Okay, for G I can insert, I can take H. Okay, I can take H or you can take J. I can take J. Okay, so here our new vertex is what? J. So explore this J, what you will get after visiting? So J having only one incident vertex, that is G is already visited. Now we are stuck here, right? There is no other incident vertex. What we will do, right? We backtracking to the G. Okay, come back to G. Okay, from G again you see already you wrote it, right? మనం ఆల్రెడీ రాసుకున్నాం కదా జీలో ఏమున్నాయి ఎఫ్ హెచ్ ఐ సో ఎఫ్ ఈజ్ ఆల్రెడీ విజిటెడ్ ఓకే and from this particular point of view, J is also visited. Okay, what is the remaining thing? Only H is there, right? Now where we are at Z, right? We are at Z. So G have a another incident vertex is what? H. Now check whether H, this is our new vertex, H existing any incident one? Yes, H have E and I. You see, I is already visited and I not visited, right? So only one element, so you can insert here. For H, you have to insert this part, okay, left part of I. And now again I have only one incident H and H is already visited, so I want to write it again. So this is the stop, we have to stop here. Okay, so next go back to H, backtracking, go back to H and come to the H. E and I is completed. Okay, go back to G. Okay, next visiting. So now G, F, H, I, H is also completed. So what, where we have to go? Backtracking to F. Now check F. F is having D, G, F. F is having how many incidents? D, E and G. D, F already visited and in this case G also visited. Okay, and again go backtracking. And what is the next element? E. So here in this case E having F, H, D, right? So all these vertices are here. F also visited and H also already visited. So again go backtracking. Okay, D. So D is having only one, D having C and E and F3, right? C already visited, E already visited and F also visited. Okay, now you are here. Now go backtracking. So what is the next element? C. Now see here, C having how many elements? A, B, D. A visited, D visited, but B is visited? No, B is still pending. So now here you insert B as a right child of C. Now what is the new element here? Here B is the new element. Explore this B. So any other adjacent vertices for this B, particular B? Yes, B have a connection with A and C, but these two are already visited, ma. Right? So no need to take the A and C because A already is there and C also there. That's it. Okay. So check it whether all the vertices is visited or not. A visited, B visited, C visited, D, E, F, G, H, I. Hi here, right? I also visited. Okay. So all the vertices are visited or not? So in our spanning tree, all the vertices is there or not? Yes, all the vertices is there. That's it. Now check whether this particular spanning tree is a correct or not, correct one or not. How we can check? How many vertices are there? N is equal to 10 vertices are there. I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 vertices are there. So our outcome is what? Here in this spanning tree, how many edges would be there? It will be there how many? 10 minus 1, right? 9 edges should be there in the spanning tree. So check it. 9 edges are there or not? So this is 1 and this is 2 and this is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and this one is 8 and this one is 9. So how many edges? 9 edges are there. Okay. So our spanning tree is correct one. Okay. Like this you have to construct the spanning trees with the help of DFS. Okay. Now we will see another example. So draw a spanning tree by using DFS. So for this particular example also, he mentioned that A should be the root node. Okay, so A should be the root node and what is the conditions? Explore this particular vertex. How we can explore? We have to take only one next incident vertex. So A have the incident with B and A incident with G. Okay, so what we will take? We'll take anyone. Okay, I'll take A to B. Okay, so what is the now vertex? Is B. Explore B. Okay, explore B. So how we can explore? Write down what are the incident for B. B have the incident with A, B have the incident with C and B have the incident with G. Okay, three numbers are there. B, A, C, G. Okay, so I'll take G. Okay, because A is completed. Okay, among C and G, I can take G. So what is the next element? G na? Okay. G will be the next element. You can take anyone, C or G, any edena this coach miru. Okay. So this is our neo element. So G having connection with A and G have a incident with L and B and H. Four are there. Okay, well. Now see, A is already visited. And what about B? B already visited. And the remaining elements are what? L and H. So among L and H, which element you can take? You can take any one. So you can take L. L or H. L this kunam. Okay na? So now our vertex will be L. Explore this L. L having the G only one H. L having the G only one H. Clear ma? So G already visited, right? We should not take it again. So backtracking. So here in this particular strap, backtracking is started. So we have to go back to J. So check it J. G dekhera. Check cheyandi. A is completed. L is also already visited. B is visited. And what is the remaining? H. So you have to insert H here. Now what is the new element here? H. Now explore H. H have incident with C, G, I and M. Okay. C, Z, I, M. Is it 4? Yes. 4 is there. So C already visited. C, not C. G. G already visited. Okay. Is it visited I and M? No. So can we take anyone? Yes, you can take M. Okay, M tiskundam. So insert M here. We'll take M. So M is visited. Okay, after visiting plus cross it so that you can understand easily. Okay ma? So M is completed. Now check whether now our new vertex is M. So M having the edges with the incident with the H and I and what about D? How many? 1, 2, this is M, right? This is M. Only 1, 2. H, I matrame unnai. Okay, not D. Only H and I. So see, H is already visited now. Yes. Right? So what is the only element? Only I is the remaining element. Now check I. See here. What about I here? I here. So how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 edges. 6 incident vertices are there. What are those? For I, H, D, E, J and what is this? N and M. Right? M is visited again already. H is visited already. D is not visited. E is not visited. J is not visited. N is not visited. You can take any one of them. Okay? We'll take J. Can we take J? Yes. So insert J here. Okay. Now explore J. How we can explore the J? See here. J here. So J having how many vertices? 4 vertices. Incident vertices. J having E and K and I have N and also I. Okay. So among these I is already visited. What about N? N is not visited. And what about K? Not visited. And what about E? Not visited. So can I insert any one of them? Yes, you can insert E, K, N. So I'll take here E. E as a next vertices. So my new vertices is what? E. Okay. So check it. What are the adjacent vertices for the E? E having 3 incident. D, F, J. You see, J is already completed. What about F? F not completed. And what about D? D also not completed. Still. Okay. So you can take anyone. Yes. I will take F. You can take F. Okay. Or a D. Anyone. Edina meeru teeskochu. Or you can take D. Okay. I will take D here. Now check. You can explore the D. Now D. Check the what are the incident for the D. D having only 2 incidents. That is D edge with E. And D have a path with I. Okay. See here. E and I. Both are visited now. Here E is there. Here I is there. So both are visited. So no need to write it again. You should stop here. And go back to backtracking. E. Now check E here. Where is the E? Here. So what is the paths existing? J already visited. D already visited. And what is the remaining element? F. Now you have to insert F. Now check F here. Your new element is what? F. Now F will be F is having K is a one path incident and F is a path with E. Okay, FE and FK. Now see here, E already visited ma, right? So I can eliminate this one. And what is the remaining element only left with here? K, right? So for F, we have to insert here K. And explore K. So K having what is the element? J and F. J and F. You see, J already visited, F is already visited. Okay? So there is no other elements incident with K. So we should stop here and we come back. Backtracking has to be done. So we come back to F and check with the F. F having only two incident, K and E. Those two are also completed. And go back to E and check with the E. E is having three incidents, D, F, G. Those three are also completed. D, F, G also completed. So you can go back to J and check with J. And here, see this J here. So E is completed, K is completed. Am I correct? So what is the left with here in J? Only N. Okay, N is there. Now, what is your new vertex? N. Check with N. Okay, I write it down here. N. N is having how many vertices? Two vertices incident with J and I. You see, I and J already visited. So no need to write it again. So go backtrack to J. And J, all the vertices is completed. All the vertices is completed. And come back to I. And check with I. At I, D is completed, no? Yes, D completed. What about E? E completed. What about J? Completed. What about N? Completed. And what is the last one? M, right? So I is having D, E, H is completed, M completed, N completed, J come. All the elements are completed. All the vertices we visited already. So come back to M. Now check with M. M having only left with I, but I already visited, no? So you can eliminate this one. So go back to H. So check with H. H having C, Z, I, M, right? So I already visited, so you can delete this one. So from here, you can go back to or backtracking to G, right? So at the Z, we have H, A, L, B, H. So see, H is already completed, ma. This also visited, so no other elements. I think G having L also, right? G having, yes, L is also completed. L to G. L is also completed. Okay, so G is having A completed and H is completed and L is completed and B is completed. And now go back to G. And now go back to B. So B is having only one incident, that is A. And A already visited, so no need to write again. And finally, we come back to our root node B. Okay, so still any elements pending with root node? B and G? Only two incidents for the root node. B and G. B visited, G visited. So, all the root nodes, all the vertices, what are there in the graph is visited. Like this. This is our spanning tree. Like this, we have to construct the spanning tree. Right? And we'll see the next question. For this particular example, also third example, for this particular example also, A will be the root node. Okay. So, procedure, what is the procedure, ma, to find out the DFS? First, write out the vertex and then explore it. Explore it to what is the first vertex incident. Okay. You can take anyone among them, among the incident vertices. So, A having connection with B for this particular graph, B and E. Okay, first check how many vertices 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So, almost 20 vertices are there. So, we will get almost 19 edges will be there. Okay, in our particular spanning tree, we will get almost 19, not more than 19. Okay, if you get more than 19, it is not the spanning tree. మీకు 19 కంటే ఎక్కువ ఎడ్జెస్ వచ్చాయి అంటే అది స్పానింగ్ ట్రీ కాదు, ఏదో రాంగ్ జరిగింది అని చెక్ చేసుకోండి. 19 కంటే తక్కువ ఉండాలి మనకి స్పానింగ్ ట్రీలోని. ఓకేనా? సో ఇక్కడ చూడండి, ఏ హ్యావ్ కనెక్షన్ విత్ బి అండ్ ఈ, రైట్? సో డైరెక్ట్లీ, రైట్? సో వాట్ వీ విల్ టేక్, కెన్ వీ టేక్ బి? ఓకే, బి హియర్ అండ్ ద నెక్స్ట్ వన్, బి ఈజ్ కంప్లీటెడ్. So you can eliminate this one. And what is the next new vertices? B. And explore B. B having E and C. And also A. A is already visited, so no need to write again. And F. Right? So three elements are there. B having connection with E, C, F. Right? So we'll take E. Can we take E? Yes. You can take any one. Okay? E, C, F la edina teeskochu. So check with E. E having incident with A and B. A, B. A, B already visited. So what is the remaining one? J and F. J and F. Okay? So can we take F? I'll take here F. Okay? So F is visited. So where is the F? Here F is there visited and here F is there visited. Okay? Now what is your new vertex? F. So write down what are the vertices. B, B already visited, so no need to write it again. E, E already visited, and C, C not visited, so write down C, and the remaining one what? D. So among the C and D, you can take any one. So I'll take here C. Okay, so C is visited, write down, and here B lo koda manaki C undi kabatti, this is visited, no? So you can eliminate this one. Now, what is the next element? C, right? What is the next element? C, not D, don't be confused. So C, explore C. C explore 2. C have incident with B, F, D. B, F, D. But B already visited, F already visited, and it remaining, you see, C having actually B, E, F. Four incidents unnai manaki. Okay, na? But B completed, E completed, F completed. So only one element is what? D. So you can insert D here. Okay? You can take it any order, ma. It is not mandatory to take F first or C first or D first. Okay, na? Among those elements, you can take any one. Kabatti andariki okokkaliki okkala vastundi. Graph anedi. For example, ikkada nenu B daggara E teeskunnanu. E kaakunda meer C teeskunnaru ankonde. It will be change. Right? And what is my next element? D. Now write down what are the incident vertices for the D. So D having C and F. C and F only. So CF and already visited. Right? So we should stop here. Because there is no other elements for the D. So what we have to do? We have to backtracking. Right? So from here we have to move C. Now check C. Check with C. Check visited B, F, D. E also. So there is no other elements with the C. So again backtracking to F. Okay? From here to here. And from here to here we are moving. And next one. F. Check with F. F is having D. D already visited, no? At C. So, you can eliminate this one. Right? B and D. So, D completed, B completed. Right. So, F is also visited. So, from F to, we have to move backtracking to E. So, check with E. F, J. So, still J is pending. So, you can write J here. Now, what is our new element? J. And write down what are the incident vertices for the J. J have connection with G, H, I and also E. So E already visited, so no need to write it again. And P and K. Okay. You see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But this one is already visited. So 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So among these, anyone visited? No one is visited. So you can take anyone. So can I take G? Yes, you can take G here. Okay. So among these, you can take anyone, G or H or I or P or K. Okay, G is our new vertices. Now write down what is the next vertices, next incident vertices for the G. G has having only two vertices, H and I. I already visited. So G is having only H. So H is visited? No. So I can insert H as a next vertices. Okay. Next, what is our new vertex? H. And explore this H. H is having two vertices, G and I. G already visited. And the next one, I. Actually, this is having three, but these two are already visited. So, what is the remaining element? I. So, you have to insert the I. Okay. And what is our new vertex? I. And come to the I and explore it. So, does I existing anyone? I having H and J, but these two are already visited. So from this point you stop here and go backtracking. And H, still any elements, vertices is pending in the H? No. So go back to G. So still any pending? No. All are completed. Incident vertices all are completed at the G. So backtracking to J. So see here J. J is completed. Right? H is completed. I is completed. And what is the remaining two elements? P and K. Okay? Take anyone. I'll take P. Okay? I'll take what? P. Now explore P. Explore P. So what is the elements? P, Q, P have incident with R and P incident with T. P actually incident with J. J already visited, so I don't want to waste the place. So I'm not writing the already visited vertices. Okay, hope you understand. So Q or T, among Q or T, will take anyone. I'll take Q. Okay, so Q visited. Now explore Q. Q having P, P already visited, Q having R incident and Q incident with S. So among R and S, among R and S, will take anyone? I will take R. Okay, I will take R. So R is visited. Ma, here P also we have the R. So you can visit this one. So eliminate this one. And next, what is our new vertex? R. Right? Our new vertex is what? R. So explore R. R having the Q already visited, and R have R incident with P visited, and the remaining two S and T. S and what? T. S is visited? No. Is T is visited? No. You can take anyone. Can we take Q? S or T? We'll take S. Okay. We'll take S. So S is removed from here, and S should be removed from here. Now check S. Where we are? S. Right? Yes, having incident with Q and R and T. Yes, incident with Q, R and T. But Q is already visited, R visited, and what is the remaining element? Only T. Okay? So T anywhere here? Yes, for this particular P also, T is there. So you can eliminate this one. So now the next element will be T. So T is having any incident? Yes, T have incident with P and R and S, but these all three are already visited. P is there, R is there, and S is there. Right? So now how we can do? We have to backtracking to the next part. Yes. So from here S to we have to move. Is there any still pending? R is completed, right? So from S to we backtracking to R. So at R any still pending? R is T is all completed. So from R to we backtracking to Q. So check it Q. Q having only two na P and S. So P and S both are visited. So we backtracking to P. So P is having J. All these elements are completed. Right? At P, all these elements are completed. So again backtracking to J. So from J, any vertices is still pending? Yes, K is pending. What is that? K is pending. So can we insert the K? Yes, we have to insert the K. Okay, explore K now. Explore K now. So what are the next incident vertices for the K? Ma, K having O, J is there, but you can eliminate that one. J already visited. So K, L and N and M, four vertices have. Right? So can we take anyone? Yes, you can take O. You can take anyone. O, all, N, M. Lo, edina me teeskochu. So I'll take here O and my new vertex is O and I explore this vertices. So now check O having any new vertices. It is incident with K and N. But K already visited, no? So no need to take. So what is the left element? Only N. So you should take N only. And you explore the N. N is having two vertices again. Okay, now O, K and M. O already visited, K already visited, and what is the remaining element? M. Okay, now our new vertices is M. Right, my new vertices is what? 1, M. Explore this M. How we can get M having how many vertices? M incident with K, M incident with L, M incident with N. But here still N is completed and K is completed. What is the remaining element? L. L should be inserted here and my new vertices will be L. Okay, explore the L. L have a connection with K and next to any more elements? L have a connection with M. Okay, so K already visited, no? No need to take. And M is also visited, no need to take. And here we stop the session. And just to go back to M. Still we should not stop like this. We have to stop here and go backtracking to M. Still any more pending in the M. There is no pendings. L is visited. Okay, and go back to the N. There is no pendings. And go back to the O. There is no pending. And go back to the K. There is no pending. Is there any elements still pending with K? No, there is no pending, right? And go back to J, and go back to E, and go back to B, and finally go back to A. Okay, so there is no elements are pending until you reach all the elements. So still 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 elements are there. Now check how many edges are there in this particular spanning tree. Okay, see, this is a one first, and this is a second, and the third, fourth, five, and six, and seven, and eight, and nine, and 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. See, 20 vertices, 19 edges. Is this spanning tree? Yes, our tree is correct one. Right, ma? So like this, you can draw any spanning tree. ఓకే ఇక్కడ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ నేను ఏకి బి తీసుకున్నాను, మీరు ఈ తీసుకోవచ్చు. సో ఇట్ సంథింగ్ స్ట్రక్చర్ విల్ బి చేంజ్, స్పానింగ్ ట్రీ స్ట్రక్చర్ విల్ బి చేంజ్, బట్ వీ కెన్ కన్స్ట్రక్ట్ ఎన్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ స్పానింగ్ ట్రీస్ ఫర్ ఎ పర్టిక్యులర్ గ్రాఫ్. బట్ హియర్ ద మోస్ట్ అండ్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్ ఈస్ ద గ్రాఫ్ షుడ్ బి కనెక్టెడ్ వన్. ఓకే, గ్రాఫ్ షుడ్ బి కనెక్టెడ్ వన్ లైక్ దిస్. సో హోప్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ దిస్ సెషన్ టోటలీ డిఎఫ్ఎస్. And next class, I'll discuss these three examples. For these three examples, how we can construct BFS. Okay. So thank you so much. Do subscribe to our channel, Sankalp Study Success.